It's a Bible study.
இது ஒரு வேத படிப்பு.
Tuesday is Bible study.
செவ்வாய்க்கிழமை வேத படிப்பு.
So some of you that thought otherwise, you'll be disappointed. It's a Bible study.
நீங்கள் வேறு மாதிரி யோசித்திருந்தால் நீங்கள் சில வழியில் ஐயோ இது வேறு மாதிரி போறது யோசிக்கலாம் ஆனால் இது வேத படிப்பு.
And there's nothing wonderful than a Bible study.
ஒரு வேத படிப்பை விட அற்புதமான காரியம் ஒன்றும் இல்லை.
Because the entrance of the word of God brings light.
தேவனுடைய வார்த்தை உள்ளே போகும்போது அது வெளிச்சத்தை கொண்டு வருகிறது.
And when light comes, darkness flees.
வெளிச்சம் வரும்போது இருள் நீங்குகிறது.
Amen.
Amen.
I want you to tell that this person, wake up in Jesus' name.
பக்கத்தில் இருக்க பார்த்து சொல்லுங்க, இயேசுவின் நாமத்திலே விழித்திருங்கள், எழும்புங்கள்.
Come on. Wake up.
இயேசுவின் நாமத்திலே.
Some of them are still in the tomb. Wake them up. Tell him, arise, arise. Amen. You had a good day? Do you have a good day? Holy Spirit, continue with us. Reveal Jesus. And destroy the works of Satan. Strengthen your people.
உம்முடைய ஜனங்களை பலப்படுத்து.
Prepare us for what you have in store.
ஆண்டவரே எங்களுக்காக வைத்திருக்கிறவர்களை ஆயத்தப்படுத்து.
And grant us grace to honor you.
உம்மை கனப்படுத்துவதற்கு கிருபையை தா.
May our gathering not be in vain.
ஆண்டவரே எங்களை கூடினதை வீணாக போகக்கூடாது.
Help us maximize this time.
ஆண்டவரே எங்களோடு நீர் உதவி செய்யும்.
Transform us.
எங்களை உருமாற்றும்.
Help us become more like you, Jesus.
உம்மை போல அதிகமாக வரத்தக்கவர்களை மாற்றும்.
We thank you.
உங்களுக்கு நன்றி சொல்லு.
That your presence,
உங்களுடைய பிரசன்னம் இருக்கிறபடியா,
changes all that is wrong.
ஆண்டவரே புரியான காரியங்களை பிரசன்னம் மாற்றுறபடியா உங்களுக்கு நன்றி.
Your presence brings the best out of our lives.
எங்கள் ஜீவியத்தில் உங்களுடைய பிரசன்னம் தான் அப்பா சிறந்ததை கொண்டு வரும்.
Oh Lord,
ஓ கர்த்தாவே,
have your way in our hearts.
எங்கள் இதயத்தில் உம்முடைய வழி நடக்க.
Give us divine understanding.
ஆண்டவரே தெய்வீக புரிந்துகொள்ளல் எங்களுக்கு தா.
And trust in you.
நாங்கள் உண்மை நம்புகிறோம்.
Help us, Lord,
எங்களுக்கு உதவி செய்ய.
To be like you.
உம்மை போல இருக்கிறது.
This is our heart desire.
இதான் எங்கள் இதயத்தின் வாஞ்சை.
We know all our needs are met in you, Jesus.
ஆண்டவரே உம்முக்குள்ளே எங்களுடைய எல்லா தேவைகள் சந்திக்கப்படும் என்பது எங்களுக்கு தெரியும்.
So we rest in your love.
ஆவே உம்முடைய அன்பிலே நாங்கள் ஓய்ந்து கொள்கிறோம்.
And thank you.
உமக்கு நன்றி.
For your miracles.
உம்முடைய அற்புதங்களுக்காக.
In Jesus' name.
இயேசுவின் நாமம்.
We pray with thanksgiving.
நாங்கள் நன்றியோடு ஜெபிக்கிறோம்.
Amen.
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 Please tell the person, don't disturb me in this service.
அப்பக்கத்துக்கு அப்பா சொல்லுங்கள், இந்த ஆராதனையில் என்ன நீங்கள் தடை செய்ய வேண்டாம்.
Now let's do it. Come on.
அப்ப இப்போ செய்ய பக்கத்தை அப்பா சொல்லுங்கள், என்ன நீங்க குழப்ப போட்டா நான் ஆராதனை கவனிக்க வேண்டும்.
Look at him again. Look at him again.
மீண்டும் பார்த்து சொல்லுங்க, என்ன குழப்பாதீர்கள்.
Tell him, if you disturb me in this service, come on. If you disturb me in this service, you become the devil and I'll cast you away in Jesus'
name.
What are the things that the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ, wants us to grasp tonight?
In the ராத்திரி வேளையிலே பரிசுத்த ஆவியானவர், கிறிஸ்துவின் ஆவியானவர் ஒரு காரியத்தை நாங்கள் பெற்றுக்கொள்ள விரும்புகிறார்.
It's God's program.
தேவனுடைய திட்டம்.
God's program.
தேவனுடைய திட்டம்.
God's agenda.
தேவன் எங்களுக்காக வச்சிருக்கிற செயல் திட்டம்.
God's objective.
தேவனுடைய குறிக்கோள்.
God's goal for your life.
உங்களுடைய ஜீவத்துக்கான தேவனுடைய இலக்கு.
God's ultimate for humanity.
மனிதர்களுக்காக தேவனுடைய இறுதி காரியம்.
God's dream.
தேவனுடைய கனவு.
That's what we want to discuss tonight.
அதைத்தான் இந்த ராத்திரி விழாவில் கலந்துரையாட போறோம்.
When we discover that,
அதை நாங்கள் தெளிவாக புரிந்து கொள்ளும்போது,
the crooked will be made straight.
அதை போனவர்கள் நேராக,
the sick be healed.
அதை நோயுள்ளவர்கள் குணம் பெறுவார்கள்.
Those in bondage will be liberated.
அதை கட்டுகளில் இருக்கிற விடுதலை பெறுவார்கள்.
There will be divine supply for every need.
தெய்வீகமாக ஒவ்வொரு காரியத்தையும் ஆண்டவர் சந்திப்பார்.
There will be a quickening of those that are dead and cold.
அங்கு குளிராக இருக்கிறவர்கள் அவர்கள்
உற்சாகப்படுவார்கள்.
மேலான ஒரு முன்னேற்றத்தை காண்போம்.
In every area of our life to his glory.
எங்களுடைய ஜீவத்தின் ஒவ்வொரு பகுதியிலும் அவருடைய நாமத்தின் மகிமைக்காக காண்போம்.
If you are ready, say amen.
ஆமென்.
Let's go to Isaiah 46. Verse
8-11.
Isaiah 46.
Verse 8-11.
Can we have it on the screen? Isaiah 46, 8-11. This is a Bible study. And this is my church. So I'm taking my time. I want to make sure by the time you walk out of this door, angels are following you, not demons. By the time you leave here, it's goodbye. Goodbye to any contraband goods. Unpermitted goods. Baggages of darkness. Now listen. He said, listen then, listen. You wanton creation. Oh, what version is that?
46.
HIV?
46. 46.
Okay, now listen, because of time, we'll run quickly. He says, remember this. Everybody say that. Remember this. Say that again. Remember this. Say that again. Remember this. Fix it in mind. Say that. No. I can't hear you. Remember this. Fix it in mind. Take it to heart. Let's do it again. Number one. Remember this. Number two, fix it in mind. Number three, take it to heart. Number one is what? Number two, fix it in mind. Number three. That's the only time in scripture that God uses similar phrases to express something that is important to him. Please tell the next person, in case your coconut forget everything.
Tell him,
in case your coconut forget everything. Tell the next person, I want you to talk to the next person. Tell him, in case your coconut forget everything. Don't forget this. Tell him, remember this. Touch the coconut, hit the coconut. Say, remember this. Fix it in mind. And take it to your heart. Take it to heart. It means through the journey of life, from the day you were born to the day you die, there are a lot of things you will remember. But this is the most important. You've read every book from the green book to the yellow book, but remember this. Some of you have more degrees than the thermometer. You have to remember this. Remember this. You can remember a lot of things, but remember this, fix it in mind, and take it to heart. Take it to heart means cherish it, value it. It means take it seriously. Cherish this. Above all,
this
should be the most greatest
treasure.
Remember, fix it in mind. Deliberately focus on it. Deliberately focus. Deliberately focus on it. And cherish it. Value it. Take it to heart. And God knows he's talking to rebels, people who are stubborn. So he says, you are rebels. Don't look at me like that. God said that. He knows we can be very interesting. And I tell my pastor friends, I said, God has never used perfect people. The first perfect person God wanted to use was Lucifer, and look at the commotion that guy is causing around.
முதலாவது ஆட்டர் பயன்படுத்த முயற்சித்த பரிபூர்ண நபர் லூசிபர். அந்த லூசிபர்ல வந்த குழப்பங்களை யோசித்து பாருங்க.
God has never used perfect people.
தேவன் ஒரு நாளும் பரிபூர்ணவர்கள் நபர்களை பயன்படுத்தவில்லை.
People he's used are rebels in one way or the other.
தேவன் பயன்படுத்தின ஜனங்கள் ஒரு விதத்திலோ இன்னொரு விதத்திலோ அவர் பாதகர்கள் புரட்டாட்டம் செய்கிறவர்கள்.
So he says, I know you can be a little stubborn and disobedient in certain areas, but I'm after all that, please remember this, fix it in mind, take it to heart.
அவர் ஆண்டவர் அதற்குமாய் மத்தியமாக சொல்லுகிறார், எனக்கு தெரியும் நீங்கள் முரட்டாட்டம் செய்கிறீர்கள், கீழ்படியாக காரியங்கள் கூடிய வாழ்க்கையிலிருந்து அவைகள் மத்தியிலும் இதை எடுத்துக்கொள்ளுங்கள், நினைத்துக் கொள்ளுங்கள், இதயத்திலே வாங்கிங்கள்.
When you run through Genesis to Revelations, you'll be amazed some of the people God used.
ஆதியாகமத்திலிருந்து வெளிப்படுத்துவதற்கு நீங்கள் போனால் நீங்கள் ஆச்சரியப்படுவீர்கள். தேவன் பயன்படுத்தின சில ஜனங்களை பார்க்கும்போது,
Adam and Eve was created perfect by God. They did not even have childhood upbringing such that they will have any childhood distortion. God created them perfect.
ஆதாமை ஏவாளை மாட்டர் பயன்படுத்தும்போது அவர் சிருஷ்டித்தபோது பரிபூர்ணமாக அவர் சிருஷ்டிக்க கூடியவர். அவருக்கு சிறு பிள்ளைகள் அனுபவமா இல்லை, ஆண்டவர் சிருஷ்டித்தார்.
Yet they ate one wrong dinner and all of us are in trouble
today. ஒரு பிள்ளையான இரவு உணவை சாப்பிட்டார், அது நிமித்தம் எல்லோரும் என்று குழப்பத்தில் இருக்கிறோம்.
Adam did not even ask where the food was coming from.
ஆதாம் எங்கிருந்து இந்த உணவு வந்ததுன்னு கேட்கவே இல்லை.
It was so easy for Adam to fall. That is why when the devil came to the garden, he did not even greet Adam. He went straight on to Eve.
Adam vidavathukku vilaguvaan adanaya than ami satan eden thottukku vandapodu adamai avan kookavillai avan neradiyaga yovan thire podaan.
When the devil comes to your home as a man, he will not bother you. He will go straight to your wife because your wife is the powerhouse.
If he comes out of the meeting, there are more niggas. Kadala irundal ana irundal ulai avan kavanikka maata avan ungalde manaiyin edathile da povan avan manaiyin edathile vallama irukku.
And Eve was able to, you know, pass some of the exams. As God said, you shouldn't eat everything. No, God said we should eat everything except this one. Pass. Second one, he failed the first. She failed the second exams. But first exam, she passed. Adam did not even ask where the fruit was coming in. That's men. Food. Food. They can't have food. When a man is hungry, when a man is hungry, he can even take the sun and chew it. I mean something wrong with us, man. The woman will be hungry, she will cook, she will be cleaning, she will be singing, she will be patient and go to a restaurant, sit down and eat. A man will just drop by the roadside and take something and start chewing it. We can handle hunger.
பெண்களை பார்க்கும் போது அவர்கள் பசியா இருந்தால் அவர்கள் உணவு தயாரிப்பார்கள், எல்லாத்தையும் சுத்தம் செய்வார்கள், அதன் பின்பு அந்த ரெஸ்டாரண்ட் போய் சாப்பிட. ஆண்களோ பசி வந்தால் வழியில் என்னத்தை கிடந்தாலும் சாப்பிடுவார்.
God doesn't use perfect people.
தேவன் ஒரு நாள் பரிபூர்ணவர்களை நபர்களை பயன்படுத்துவதில்லை.
The devil went straight to Eve.
பிசாசு நேரடியாக ஏவாளத்திலே போனது.
You know, women were the first to talk to the devil.
பெண்கள் தான் முதலாவதாக பிசாசுடன் பேசினார்கள்.
So the women can smell the devil 80 meters radius from your house before it gets there. That's why men must listen to their wife. Because before the devil shows up, you say, honey, be very careful. They were the first to talk to the guy, so they know the guy very
well. வீட்டுக்கே பிசாசு 80 மீட்டர் தொலைவில் வரும்போது கூட பெண்களுக்கு தெரியும், ஆனவர் தான் பெண்களுக்கு ஆண்கள் செவிசாய்க்க வேண்டும்.
They will be the last to deal with the devil. They will be the last. They were the first to talk to the devil.
அவர்கள் முதலாவது அவங்க பெண்கள் தான் பிசாசோடு பேசுவார்கள், ஆனால் பிசாசை கையாளுவது அவர்கள் தான் கடைசியாக.
So they will be the last to deal with the devil. They will whip the devil before Jesus comes. That is why the church of Christ is the bride of Christ.
அவர்கள் கடைசியாக.
We will whip the devil before Jesus comes.
இயேசு வரும்போது பிசாசை அவர் அழைத்து கூட ஆண்டவர் தான் கிறிஸ்துவோட சபை சொல்லப்படுகிறது, அதாவது மனவாட்டி சபை.
Amen.
Amen.
So God looked at Adam and Eve and said, these guys. Then he moved on to Noah.
And Adam and Eve and father went to Noah's boda.
Noah came out of the ark drunk naked.
Noah parkum bodu avan perilirundu varum bodu avan kudi bodiyodu nirvanamaga vandan.
The righteous man.
Needhiman. Noah.
And that's the only church, and that is the only pastor there. You can't go to any church.
And the only pastor there is Noah.
So some of you that want a perfect church, join it. You can never find a perfect church. If you find a perfect church, don't join it. You will make it imperfect. Every one member added to a church is one problem added to a church. Example, how many of you have problems here? Lift your hands. Those who have lifted their hands are telling the truth. The rest need deliverance from the spirit of lies. If you have problems here, lift your hands. I'm serious. If you have problems here, lift your hands. Pastor, you see? Some of them have lifted their two hands and two legs here. Problems. So anytime you pray, God increase the church, it means increase the problem. Noah, Pastor Noah is drunk naked. And if you go to announce it out there, God will bang your head. So God moved on. And then found Abraham.
Abraham
from Iraq. He comes from Iraq. So God said, Abby, come here, Abby.
Abby, you
I want to bless the whole world through you. Thank you very much. But I don't have a son. I don't have any child. God said, I'll give you children.
No.
A long time the baby not coming. Then Mrs. Abraham.
Mrs. Abraham.
Sarah advised Abraham. This Bible God is too slow. Let's help him. And Sarah brought Hagar. Interesting. Where did Hagar come from? Abraham went to Egypt. He's afraid that they'll kill him. So he told Sarah, when they ask you, tell him you are my sister.
ஆபிரகாம் எகிப்துக்கு போறதுல அவர் பயந்தான் தன்னை கொலை செய்வார் நடபடியாக சாராளுக்கு சொன்னார் நீங்களுடைய சகோதரி என்று சொல்லுங்க.
And the king took Sarah and God showed up in the night and said, if you touch this lady, I'll kill you. The king got up and said, all of you leave my country. Goodbye. And they gave Abraham gifts, and one of the gifts was Hagar. Be careful of the gifts you receive by disobeying God. Some of you call everything a breakthrough, but some breakthroughs are breakdowns. Hello, are you still sleeping? Some breakthroughs are breakdowns. So Abraham goes in with Hagar. Then Ishmael is produced. Ishmael means tears. God has heard my cry. Ishmael means tears. Then after a while, Isaac is born. Isaac means laughter. So in the same house, you have tears and laughter. And at times, that is how our Christian life is. At times, that's how a life in Christ is. One side you are crying, one side you are laughing. Then Sarah, the same Sarah, came to the husband and said, please, you have to drive Ishmael and his wife. You can never understand women. Don't try, you can't.
Your
coconut cannot comprehend. Strange
machines.
One of my sons in ministry, he was asking, he said, Papa, why is women so complex? I said, it's simple. When God created them, we were sleeping. When we woke up, the thing was done. Adam was sleeping. By the time he woke up, there comes the dinosaur. In so we will fully not understand them. We need a manual for them from the manufacturer. What buttons to press at certain times? When a woman says no, she means I'm thinking about it. If she says yes, it means be careful. You need the spirit of discernment. And that's why the church of Jesus Christ is so complex. The church is female. We are the bride of Christ. We are so complex. God has never used perfect people. God's friend is Abraham, and he created the greatest problem in producing Ishmael. Until now, that problem has not been solved. The greatest problem. God loved Abraham so much, he named heaven after him. He called heaven the bosom of Abraham. Yet he created the greatest mistake that has not been solved up to today. And you move on to Isaac. Like father, like son. Like father. His father said the wife was a sister. Isaac also told the same lie. As for Jacob, let's not talk about him. That guy is a rascal. It was so bad that when Jacob was meeting Esau, he sent his servants ahead and his wife and children next. And he was behind. So it means when they kill the servants, by the time they kill the wives and children, he is gone. And God is not and yet God said, Jacob, I love, Esau, I hate. I said, no, God. You need to Google the name of Jacob. The guy is bad. You need to read the newspapers. This guy is a bad guy. God will not listen to me. He said, Jacob, I love Esau. I said, no. It was rather Jacob who stole the birthright of Esau. So you need to love Esau and hate Jacob. He said, shut up, Bernard. I love Jacob. I hate Esau. I mean, the guy was so fast that God had to slow him down. All of Jacob's life, he has to. Pastor, you didn't do that. He had to limp. That is why when I meet people who say they have had an encounter with Jesus, they have had an encounter with God, and they are walking all straight and active. When you really touch God, when God touches you, Anybody that has touched God, you see a limp. Jesus pleased the Father. Now when you go to heaven, you ask Jesus, Jesus, how was it like? He said, look into my hands. You see the nail pierced hands, you see the side. This is what it means to touch the Father. Nobody is entering heaven unscratched. No. You would have to pay some little price. Jesus paid the greatest price. But he knows us as human beings. We don't value anything we don't pay a price for. So he's left us a little weedy, bitty price to pay. And everybody would have to pay some price
to see the fullness.
Some would enter heaven with one leg. Others with one eye. Oh yes. It's going to cost you something. If you want to be the learner of Jesus, a disciple of Christ, you deny yourself and take up the cross. The cross is not for decoration.
There
will be something you have to wrestle with.
ஏதாவது ஒரு காரியம் நீங்க போராட வேண்டிய காரியம்.
God doesn't use perfect people.
தேவனால் பரிபூர்ணங்களை பயன்படுத்த.
That's why he says rebels.
ஆண்டவர் தான் சொல்றார் போராட்டம் செய்யற ஏனா பாதகர்.
He moves on from Jacob.
அவ யாக்கோபுல இருந்து போகும்போது
then he finds Joseph.
அவ யோசேப்.
This guy talks too much.
யோசேப் அதிகமாக கலைந்தார்.
Wears coat of many colors.
அதிகம் பல வர்ணங்கள் உள்ள அங்கி அணிந்திருந்தார்.
He will not do the dishes.
He
would do nothing in the house. The brothers would go and work and bring the food home, cook. He would eat, sleep, and dream that all of them are bowing down to him. And the next morning, the mouth is like a kitchen knife. He would be telling them, all of you are going to bow down. Thank God I was not one of the brothers out of just. He talks too much. You don't tell everybody what God shows you.
It's
premature. The brothers hated him. So God said, this guy talks too much. I'll prepare a nice designer pit. So God made sure there was a pit designed for Joseph. How do I know? There was no snake in the pit. God was behind the whole show. So he's there alone in the pit. And there are no cell phones to call anybody and talk. Still, I believe in the pit, he's still talking to himself. To Pharaoh's house. He's still talking. When Joseph was accused, not one person defended him in Pharaoh's house. Because he's a relatable guy. He talks. The next day in the news front page of the newspapers, you see Mrs. Potiphar holding Joseph's jacket. With her face as if she's been baptized in lemon juice. In court, they will ask Joseph, were you wearing this shirt that day?
Yes.
Did you enter that room?
Yes.
Case closed. You are the one. And I tell Christians, be careful of what you hear and read. Because at times the truth and the falsehood are very close. That if you don't have a discerning ear and a discerning eye, you'll be deceived.
It is easy. உண்மைக்கும் அங்கே வேறுபாடு இல்லாமல் மிகவும் நெருக்கமாக இருக்கின்றது. அவை பகுத்தறிவாக இல்லாவிட்டால் நாங்கள் பொய்யான காரியங்கள் உண்மையாக நாம் விரும்புவோம்.
They are showing something on TV now about Jesus. And it will get to a point where they will tell you Jesus had babies, he was married, he had babies and all that. And they will be removing some tombs from Jerusalem. Turn off your TV. Because that thing called TV is tell your vision. That thing tells your vision. When you see that thing, switch it off. It's blasphemy. God hasn't used perfect people. Joseph goes to prison, he's still talking. You know, when the king restores you, remember me. And God said, the guy is still talking. So he makes sure Joseph is forgotten. And when he kept quiet, God gave Pharaoh a dream that brought Joseph into the palace. Joseph never trained anybody. I'm tired of going through pain. I've forgiven you. Stay in your corner. I stay here. I don't want any of you close to me. When Joseph died, there was no Jew that carried his legacy. He never transferred that jurisdictional anointing, that governance anointing with anybody, to anybody. He made provisions for his bones to be carried away when they are living. But he never prepared the next generation. There was no Jew that Joseph trained. God doesn't use perfect
people.
And God moved on to Moses. He's a murderer. He's killed somebody. And the police are searching for him. And the guy runs away. And after 40 years, God appears to this murderer. I said, Moses, you're going back to Egypt. God, I can't speak. Oh yeah, I know why you can't speak. You are scared. But you are going back to Pharaoh. God, you don't read the internet. You have to be on the net. I don't have a good record there. They want to arrest me there. He said, you go back. And 3 million Jews came out of bondage. 430 years of slavery was ended by an ex-murderer. God said Moses was the meekest man. God said, but the meekest man had an anger problem. He brought the Ten Commandments and broke it himself. He brought it and broke it. God said, Moses, come back up the mountain 40 days without chicken biryani. The meekest man had an anger problem. God said, speak to the rock. And from and oh, Moses. Don't do that. You will see Canaan, but your legs, your foot will never touch there. 80 years of training is over. Hasta la vista. Come up the mountain. Let me conduct your funeral. God doesn't use perfect people. That's why when the God of the Bible takes hold of your life, or you start being devoted to Him, you need to be cautious.
எடுத்துக்கொள்ளும்போது நீங்கள் கவனமாக இருக்க வேண்டும்.
Don't let arrogance and pride set in where you condemn everybody and feel you are better than anybody.
பெருமை நிமித்தமாக மற்றவர்கள் எல்லாவற்றையும் நீங்கள் கடிந்து கொண்டு மற்றவர்களால் உதவாதன் சொல்ற நிலைமைக்கு வரவை விட கொடுக்க வேண்டாம்.
80 years
80 வருடம்
of hard labor
அதிகமான கடின உழைப்பு அது எல்லாம் கூட
please God let me just step there for no
தேவனே தயவு செய்தால் ஒரு முறை கால் வைக்கட்டும் ஆண்டவரே
But God in His mercy, knowing He doesn't use perfect people, years after Moses is dead and being in heaven, God called Moses from heaven and said, come here, I want you to go back to the same land. The same land I said you shouldn't go. You go back on the Mount of Transfiguration, you go and stand there and advise Jesus. You know how to miss it. You tell Jesus not to miss it. You go advise Him. Use your experiential knowledge to talk to Him. That you can't miss it. Don't do what I did.
பயப்படுத்தும்படி அவர் செய்கின்றார் அவன் அவன் பெற்ற அவன் அடைந்த தோல்வியை இயேசுவோடு சொல்லும்படியாக அவர் மோசேயை அவர் மறுவ மலையிலே அந்த கானான் தேசத்தை விரிக்க
வைக்கின்றார் After years of death in heaven, now steps on the land that God told him about. I believe he's talking to Jesus and looking around. Faithfulness of God. When God wants to give you advices, He doesn't give you advices who look successful. He would give you people who have been through the crucible of life and survived the test of time. He said, Elijah, you also come because you were also substituted. I told you to anoint Elisha in your place, which means you were substituted. So you and Moses understand how to not finish what you started. And you can advise Jesus when you go to Calvary and they slap you. Don't complain. They hit you, don't complain. When the spittle comes, wow, don't complain. Make sure you endure it. Don't do what we did.
தேவன் ஆலோசனை சொல்வதற்கு பயன்படுத்தும் போது பரிபூர்ண நபர்களை பயன்படுத்துவார்கள் அனுபவம் உள்ளவர்கள் அனுபவத்து கூட போனவர்களை பயன்படுத்துகிறார் எலியாவையும் தேவன் அங்கு அழைக்கக்கூடிய இருந்தது எலியா தேவன் சொல்லக்கூடிய இருந்தது உன்னுடைய இடத்துல உனக்கு பதிலாக எலிசாவை நீ அபிஷேகம் என்ற கருத்து எலியாவுடைய வேலை முடிந்தது அவை எலியாவையும் அவர் அழைத்து அந்த பயன்படுத்துகிறார் அவை அது எலியாவும் மோசேயும் அங்கு இயேசுக்கு சொன்ன காரியம் என்று நாங்கள் அடைந்த தோல்வி நீங்கள் அடையக்கூடாது உங்களை காரை துப்பும் போது அடிக்கும் போது நீங்கள் பொறுத்துக் கொள்ளுங்கள் சொல்லக்கூடிய
How Christians condemn pastors and leaders who have gone through crisis we abandon them we throw them away that is the jewels that's the cream of the crop they are called veterans And you need to tap into wisdom, experiential knowledge from these veterans. And that's why ministries don't last these days. Because we lack links to people who have been through the battle and have survived the test of time. And they'll be able to tell you, don't do this, do it this way, because I've been there. A pastor was talking to me. He said, he's a prophet. That pastor has fallen from grace. I said, so you are standing in grace, huh? And he was telling me the pastor has fallen from grace. I asked him, are you standing in grace?
You standing in grace.
If a TV screen is brought here and your life is exposed on the screen, people will fall down. People will collapse.
TV screen
it is by grace you are. We are all work in progress, buildings under construction. And if by grace you are stronger in one area, oh, humbly restore others that are weak in that area. Because it could have been different for you. God doesn't use perfect people.
So
he says, you rebels. You move on in scripture. You find Elijah. A woman wrote a letter to Elijah. Elijah immediately becomes suicidal. This is a guy who has sent fire from heaven. He started running away. God kill me. God kill me.
Elia, I am a
Jezebel said, tomorrow about this time. At least Elijah have 24 hours. I believe the speed of Elijah could break the record of Usain Bolt. He was running. The prophet was running. Suicidal. God kill me. God kill me. And how can you be running and saying God should kill you at the same time? If you want to die, stand where you are for Jezebel to catch up with you. So his mouth is saying one thing, his heart means another. And God said, Elijah, listen. If I'm going to be one of these extreme faith teachers, confession brings possession. Since you are asking for death, I'll let you die immediately. But I'm beyond that. I'm going to send a heavenly limousine, chariots of fire, to carry you to heaven. I don't even want you to taste physical death, so my enemies will laugh at me because you bear my name. So he asked for death, God gave him double life. He asked for death, God gave him double life. A guy was asking for death, did not taste death. Was transfigured. Elisha. Not good.
Elia.
The most stingy prophet I've ever met. Elisha had double anointing. He never passed it on to anybody. He died with the anointing still in his bones. When a dead body was thrown on his grave, the dead body came back to life. But his associate pastor, Gehazi, was walking empty, stealing money from people, taking money from people. Selfish. Anointed but selfish. Never trained anybody. There was a school of prophets. Elisha did not train anybody. Elijah trained Elisha. But Elisha did not train anybody. When Elisha died, there was no prophet in the land. He never trained anybody. It was only me, myself, and I. The trinity of self. Me, myself, and I. They never trained anybody. Selfish. To a point that children were playing with Elisha. Bald head. You know children pray. You know they play. Bald head. They were dancing. Bald head. I thought Elisha would dance with the children. He commanded a bear to come. This is a Taliban prophet. He commanded a bear to come from the forest and eat up the children. Can you imagine a child and a bear would take the eye of the child? Oh, and blood is coming. And Elisha is standing there unmoved. Blood is coming out. And a bear would take the hand of a child. Pull it out, and blood is oozing out, and that prophet is not moved one inch. And we have such prophets in the body of Christ now. ISIS prophet. These are suicide bombers. They are anointed but wicked in heart. Wicked, adamant. They have no feelings for people. No fellow feeling. No compassion. No sensitivity. They don't care about anybody. Anointed but wicked.
எலிசா செய்த காரியம் என்ன அவர் சிறு பிள்ளைகள் பார்த்து அவர் மொட்டத்தை யார் சொன்னபோது அவன் கரடியை வரவழைத்துள்ள பிள்ளைகள் கொலை செய்யப்படுவதை பார்த்தான் ஆனால் அவனும் அசையவில்லை மனதிற்கும் இல்லை அன்பு இல்லை அப்படிப்பட்ட ஒரு தீர்க்கதரிசி இருந்தான் இன்று உலகத்தில் அப்படித்தான் சில தீர்க்கதரிசிகள் காண்கிறோம் மனதிற்கும் இல்லை அன்பு இல்லை ஆனால் அபிஷேகம் பெற்று சொல்கிறார் கடினமான இதயம் உண்மை
When you go to a meeting with such people, you need a spiritual bulletproof.
அப்படிப்பட்ட இடங்களுக்கு நீங்கள் கூட்டங்களுக்கு போகும்போது குண்டுகளை பாதுகாக்கக்கூடிய கவசம் தேவை.
When angels even see such creatures, they take cover.
அங்கே தேவதூதன் அப்படிப்பட்ட கிரியைகளை காணும்போது அவர் ஒதுங்கிக் கொள்கிறார்.
Yet God used him.
ஆனால் அப்படி இருக்கும் தேவனுடைய
Who am I to judge him?
அவர் எப்படி நாங்கள் நியாயத்தீர்ப்பு
He used perfect people.
தேவன் பரிபூர்ணங்களை பயன்படுத்தவில்லை.
And in God's hall of fame in Hebrews 11, he lists their names. Who am I to say? None of Samuel's children followed God. None of them served God. Samuel, the mighty prophet, none of his children followed God.
Samuel,
they rebelled against all his children.
Samuel,
If someone is living today, he doesn't have the moral right to lead a church. Because Paul says that if you cannot control your own house, how can you lead the church? So at times when I see some people quote the scripture just to have a reason to hate somebody, a reason to bring somebody down or devalue somebody, I laugh. Because the word of God is a whole piece. You can't take one scripture and overstretch it. It has to link up with all the truths.
தேவனுடைய வார்த்தையை பார்க்கும் போது அது எல்லாவற்றோடு சேர்ந்து இருக்கின்றது ஒரு வார்த்தையை எடுத்து மட்டும் நாங்கள் கொள்கைகளை உண்டாக்க முடியாது அவர் சில பேர் வேத வார்த்தைகளை கொண்டு சொல்லும் போது நான் சிந்திப்பது என்ன சொல்லுவார்கள்
Isaiah was a wimp.
Isaiah,
a coward, afraid. Isaiah never saw the Lord until the king died. And the year King Uzziah died, then Isaiah opened his eyes. The year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord high and lifted up. Shut up. When the king was alive, why didn't you see the Lord? He was afraid if he speaks, they will cut off his head. So he waited till the king died and said, Hallelujah, I saw the Lord. Jeremiah was another dangerous prophet. God gave him a prophecy about the exile of the Jews, and he gave him a specific time that it will happen. And Jeremiah prophesied that. But the time came to pass and the prophecy has not come to pass. The prophecy was not fulfilled, which means everybody was looking at him as a false prophet. For his reputation's sake, Jeremiah is very angry. So in Jeremiah chapter 12, he says, God, you know me. You know how nice I am. These people are wicked. He said, draw them like sheep to the slaughter. It means kill them all. He's a Taliban prophet. Kill them.
அவன் எப்படி இஸ்ரேல் ஜனங்கள் போவார்கள் என்று அவன் சொல்ல முடியாது ஆனாலும் அவனுடைய தீர்க்கதரிசனம் ஏற்ற காலத்தில் நிறைவேறாத படியினாலே அவன் எளிமையா கர்ணமதிகாரத்துக்கு வரும்போது அவன் சொல்கிறான் தேவனை நோக்கி என்னை தெரியும் ஆனால் அவரை அந்த ஜனங்களை கொலை செய்ய மாட்டேன் அவன் சொல்லுகின்றான்
He said, Jerry, if you are running with human beings on foot and they are making you frustrated and weary, how can you run with horses?
You are built for the supernatural.
I've built you to handle complex situations. In short, don't be frustrated. Take it easy. Who?
Yeah.
David.
Samuel.
Ayo. I don't want to talk about it. It was so bad that David was not moving, and the elders of the church said, We know the problem. So they found a little girl and released the little girl into David's bedroom, and David started moving. But God sends a man after my heart. David counted the soldiers in Israel to know how many soldiers he has. And God said, hey, David, oh, I see. Now you have soldiers to fight for you, and you can count them. I have been the one fighting your battles for you. Now you have a big church and you can count the numbers. And God sent one unemployed angel. How do I know that angel is unemployed? Because there are millions and billions and quintillions of angels. Some of them don't have jobs. Because covenant people will not deploy them. When Christians fight their own battles, angels go on a holiday. This one angel killed 83,000 soldiers. In 3 hours, 83,000 Israeli soldiers, Jewish soldiers, died. Men, 83,000. 3 hours, one angel.
ஒரு தூதனாலே மூன்று மனத்தியாலத்துக்குள்ளே 83,000 போர் வீரர்கள் இஸ்ரவேல் போர் வீரர்கள் கொலை செய்யப்பட்டார்.
And I'm thinking, God, it's David who did the counting, in case you've forgotten. It's David. David is the one who did what was wrong. These soldiers are innocent. If they have wives and children, there will be 83,000 homes without a father. They are innocent. Is David God? Some of you that have a ministry of advising God, it's not a busy ministry. You can't advise God. No, Moses tried. He said, God, please don't kill them. The whole countries will say you brought them here to kill them. God didn't say anything. He kept quiet. And everybody said, Moses advised God. Few days after, the same people provoked Moses. And Moses hit the rock. Pow, pow. And God said, Moses, that's it. You cannot enter the promised land. And Moses said, oh, I see. Same people. Same group of people. Check the scriptures. God wiped all of them away except Joshua and Caleb entered the promised land. You can't advise God. Some of you that are in that ministry resign tonight. Can't advise him. Interesting. God doesn't use perfect people.
He doesn't.
And it's interesting when you look at David's life. It's amazing. God must deal with David. Because he's the one who has committed the error. But God channels his anger for David on 83,000 men. You know what he's trying to say? It takes me a long time to find a man like him who can bless my heart, who can worship me. And when I'm angry with him, I better redirect my anger somewhere than to touch this man. The question is, who are we to sit God down and say, God, this is wrong. That is why Paul says that, who has ever sat down with God and advised him and counseled him? He does what he pleases. That is what makes him God.
அவர் தேவன் காரணம் என்ன அவர் யோசித்து பார்த்தா தாவீது செய்த பிள்ளைக்கு 53,000 பேரை கொலை செய்யக்கூடியா இருந்தது. அங்கு தாவீது அவர் தேவனுடைய பார்வையிலே தாவீது அவருடைய இரு தேவன் இருதயத்தை கேட்டவன். அப்படிப்பட்ட மனுஷனை கண்டுபிடிப்பது தேவனுக்கு கடினம். ஆனபடியால் தான் அவர் தன்னுடைய கோபத்தை அந்த ஜனங்கள் மீது
He doesn't use perfect people.
அவர் பரிபூர்ண நபர்களை பயன்படுத்தவில்லை.
The wisest man in the Bible was Solomon.
சாலமோன் தான் வேதாகமத்திலே ஞானமுள்ள மனுஷன்.
He married 700 wives and 300 girlfriends. That is the wisest man. So you can imagine if he was not wise. God doesn't use perfect. Some of you are thinking that is Old Testament. Move to New Testament. Jesus had a visa problem. Oh yes. I said Jesus had a visa problem. He wanted to go to Samaria and the Samaritans would not allow him to come through the city. That's a visa problem. No entry. Hello, hello, are you here? Hello, wave your hand, let me see you are here. That's a visa problem. No entry. And James and John, who are deacons in the church, had a solution and said, Jesus, we have a solution. Pastor, please send fire to come from heaven and kill these people. These are ISIS deacons. And these are people Jesus prayed all night to choose. So imagine if he didn't pray at all. He prayed all night to choose these guys. Thomas doesn't believe the pastor 1 minute. He's a member of the church, he's a deacon in the church, elder, but he doesn't trust pastor 1 minute. Jesus walks on water. Thomas says, that is video. Jesus died and rose again. Thomas was busy. Somewhere in McDonald's. The guy is shopping, he's walking through the shopping mall. The church has collapsed. Jesus has died. Let me move on. He was not in the service. All the 10 were there. He was not there. So after service, they called Thomas. Hello, Thomas. Are you there? Jesus appeared in church physically. He said, what did you say? Jesus what? Appeared.
You're joking.
How can you people be deceived like that?
You
have to grow up.
Something
wrong with your coconut. So he came to church. I believe Jesus was waiting. Every Sunday Jesus would check whether he's come. He's not there. One Saturday, guess what? Thomas comes to church and Jesus appeared physically.
Hallelujah.
Thomas is also saying, hallelujah.
Thomas, hallelujah.
That is 3D imaging. Jesus said, Thomas, it's me. Thomas, now do you believe?
He said,
I'm not a small boy, you know. This thing I'm seeing, it's not real. Jesus said, Thomas, come. I thought Thomas would say, it's okay, sir. It's okay, I believe now. He came. He said, Thomas,
Toma.
Look into my hand.
¿Dónde caiga la
hipa? That is paint. He said, Thomas, touch my hand. And the guy brought the hand and touched. Oh, Pastor, oh Lord, Savior. We were saved by faith. Thomas was saved by sight. That is why when he came to India, anytime Thomas preached, there were tears in his eyes. He never felt like he qualified for the gospel. He preached the gospel with tears in his eyes all the time. He preached the gospel. But it shows the length and width and breadth and depth of God's grace. That Jesus could come so low to lift you so high. Can you give him praise for that? Peter came to church with a knife. Physically. And this knife was not for decoration, huh? It's for ministration. He has the knife. Physical. There's a person Jesus prayed all night to choose. He came to church with a physical knife. And in the presence of Jesus, how many of you know the presence of Jesus? In the presence of Jesus, he cut somebody's ear. So imagine if Jesus was absent. He would have removed the head. In the presence of Jesus, he cut somebody's ear. He didn't want to cut the ear. He wanted to divide the guy into two. Just that the guy dodged and he got the ear. This is Peter. Don't forget, he's going to be the leader of the church. Is that okay? Physically, if it is today, we will call 911. This man will be behind bars. He will be behind bars. And yet loved by God. And yet appointed to lead the church. Bleeding. People bleeding in the presence of Jesus. And that is the picture of what is happening in Christendom today. In Christianity today. There are brothers and sisters bleeding right in the church. Bleeding. Injured by men and women of God. Slashed by the tongue of Christians. Destroyed. Slandered. Horrified by negativity. We have killed many with our tongue. He came to seek and to save that which is lost, not to strangle that which is lost. He came to seek and to save, not to strangle. And Jesus, in a busy schedule to fulfill the eternal plan of God of salvation, had to stop, interrupt, and with one hand tell Peter to put that sword back in the shed. He's trying to say, this is not ministry. I didn't call you to the ministry of distraction, the ministry of messing up people, destroying people, slandering people, the ministry of messing people's lives. No! So with one hand he's stopping the wrong ministry. With another hand he's showing him the right ministry. He goes down. He said true ministry is humility. Going down to pick what is down and bring it up and fix it where it's supposed to be. True ministry is about healing what is sick. It's about restoring what is destroyed. It's about replenishing what is depleted. It's about bringing alive that which is dead. It's never about destroying and debasing and devaluing and slandering and pushing people down and bullying people with God's word. It It doesn't work like that. Jesus says, I came to seek and to save anything that is lost. If it's lost, I want to save it. If it's lost, be it a family, a girl, a boy, a business, anything lost, I want to bring it back to what it's supposed to be. That is Christianity. Rebels. Rebels. A lady comes with sick, five divorces, wrapped with five divorces, coming to meet Jesus.
And
Jesus sent the disciples, all of them, to go buy food.
Yes, it is what that is.
The food of 12 can be bought by two. He said, no, all of you go buy food. Because if you guys are here and the lady comes, you will drive her away with your stinking religious attitude. Can you imagine a lady with five divorces will have so much wounds inside and it will express outside? And at times when you see people overdressed, it's a sign of emptiness within. You know, they wear blue trousers, a yellow short, they have a green top and a red bag. You know, they are trying to tell you something. Is that okay? Such a person will dress in a certain way, very elegant. And that lady will come, and Peter and Co are around Jesus, and they see the lady coming. They'll start praying in the spirit. And immediately the lady comes, they say, sister, pastor is busy. So Jesus sent all of them to buy food and minister to this lady. The lady goes to town to bring the man to Jesus. The disciples come with food. Jesus, fish curry ready. Jesus said, I am full. You are full. Jesus said, I have food to eat you don't know. Then the lady comes with all the men. And the woman is telling them how Jesus has ministered to her. Oh, I see. So now we know where the food is coming from. The Bible says Jesus knew what was in their minds. Through that woman, there was a man's ministry initiated in Samaria that brought the men of Samaria to Christ. But you need to understand, God doesn't use perfect people. Lazarus is dead. And I'm glad for your sake. What kind of pastor are you? He's a member of the church. We've been in the house. We should pay a hospital visit. You said no. Now the man is dead. You are glad. Let's resign from the church. See, the disciples didn't get it. Thomas said, let's go with him and die. But Jesus wanted to honor the family. He's been eating in that house. He wanted to let everybody in that area know that family. And the only way he can give them a nice miracle was to have a nasty problem. How many of you want a big miracle? Father, give them a big problem. Because you can never have a big miracle without a big problem. How many of you want a beautiful miracle? Father, give them an ugly problem. Because you can't get a beautiful miracle without an ugly problem. So Jesus had to make sure Lazarus is stinking. And reveal that treasurable testimony. Lazarus doesn't have to pass out his business cards again. Everybody in the area knew him. Free adverts. This is called divine advertisement. So at times when God wants to do something significant in your life, you allow an ugly problem in your life. Then he will show himself mighty and strong on your behalf. He doesn't use perfect people. He doesn't use perfect people. Later on, the shadow of Peter was healing the sick. The guy who cut somebody's ear in church. It's now the senior pastor. I mean, imagine Pastor Thomas is arrested. And you are an associate pastor and you were called to give a testimony for him to be released. They ask you, sister, brother, do you know Pastor Thomas? He said, Pastor what? Thomas. It sounds familiar, I'm not sure. Oh, we heard that you were a member of that church. Oh no, I swear, I don't know him. That is Peter for you. I don't know him. Another person, policeman, comes in. We saw you with Pastor Thomas.
Oh, now we're both Thomas or
Ayo, Jesus, fight for me. I don't know this man. Then Jesus rose again on the third day. He's about to travel to heaven. So he's appointing a pastor for the church. Now, church, get ready. This is your pastor now. Peter. And John was the only disciple at the cross. So morally, on moral grounds, John should be the leader. And this guy, Peter, mounts the pulpit. I now know why Thomas didn't come to church.
எனக்கு இப்பொழுது தெரியும் ஏன் தோமா அங்க சபைக்கு வரவில்லை.
Because Thomas is a pragmatic man. He uses his coconut. He's trying to say that Peter doesn't deserve to
lead.
So in the family of God, you need to be careful always relying on your coconut. In God's family, you need to look beyond the coconut. Because God's ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. Rebels. Remember this. Fix it in mind. Take it to heart. God doesn't use perfect people. I want to show you the people God
used.
I want to present God's team to you. God's team. Everybody say God's team. We are about to pray, but I want to show you this. Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 26. 1 Corinthians 1:26. Let us all read it on the screen. 1 Corinthians
1:26.
We are looking at God's team. We are looking at God's team. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 26. 1 Corinthians 1:26. Let us all read up here. Brothers, think of what you were when you were called. Not many of you were wise by human standards, nor many were influential, not many were of noble birth. Continue, but, verse 27, let us read. Ready, go. But God chose the foolish thing. So, in God's team, the first people you see in God's team is foolish people. Are you? in Gosling, when God presents his cricket team, or his basketball team, or his soccer team, the first group of players you see are fools. So in case tonight you feel you are a fool, you qualify for God's team. So he chose the foolish things of this world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things. How many of you feel you are weak in one area of your life or the other? You feel you are weak in one area of your life or the other? And qualify for God's team. So when God presents his team, you see the first group foolish, the second group will begin to trot on the field, that is weak people. Weak mothers and fathers, weak brothers and sisters. Weak. The weak things of this world to shame the strong. Continue. He chose the lowly things. How many of you feel low in your spirit? At times you feel low. You wake up and you feel low. How many of you have experienced that before? Anytime you feel low, don't think you are disqualified from God's family. When you have that low spirit, that heavy spirit, when you feel like you are nothing, you feel low inside, qualify for God's team. Choose the low things of this world and the despised things. How many of you have been rejected before? Someone has rejected you before. Or looked down on you before. You feel despised. Dishonored, disrespected. So when God shows up his team, you see disrespected people. Dishonored people. You see them on the field. People who have been shamed. And the things that are not. Some of you are existing but not living. As a matter of fact, as you are sitting here, you cannot even feel yourself. It's like you feel you are not, you are nothing. You are not. I know that I am nothing. Nothing. You are not. So when you see God's team, you see people who have no sense of value. No sense of identity. They don't know who they are. Hey, Bernard Blessing, why wasn't I born to the royal family in Britain? Why was I born into this family with so many problems in this family? You feel like life has no meaning. Those who are not. They are like an atom in a gaseous state. They're just existing, floating. No sense of worth. You are in God's team. A sister met me and said, Bernard Bless, he met me at the airport. He said, "You, Bernard Bless?" I said, "Yes." He said, "Oh my God, I've had a question to ask you." I said, "I hope I have the answer."
He said,
"I've always wished that I would be like Lady Diana." Can God grant my wish? I said, if you were Lady Diana, you'd be dead by now. Yes. People who have no sense of worth, they want to copy everybody. Some have fair skin. They don't like the skin. They go and hang themselves on the sun to get dark. The dark skin also want to be fair. So now angels are confused. What is happening down there? You are fair, you want to be black. You are black, you want to be fair.
When I go to the
a lady met me and said, you know, I'm too fat. I think I have to pray that God will help me lose
weight.
I look at the sister and I look at the husband. Husband has stability. I look at the woman that wants to lose weight. As a sister, if you lose weight, the wind will carry you away somewhere. Your husband can't find you. These days, the winds that are blowing are very strong. You need some flesh for stability. Who said every man loves a skinny lady? Those who are not married, who not, let's say, I want to lose weight, it doesn't matter. Because some men don't want to marry bones, they want to touch meat. No sense of worth. You become so skinny, your husband can't find you in the bedroom. What is that? No sense of worth. You meet somebody walking like this, the next day you also start walking like that. You see a person walking like that, you also start walking like that. What is wrong? No sense of worth. Who are you? Some of you, God can't find you. God want to use you. Not Benny Hinn in you. Benny is my friend. Pastor Benny is my friend. But not Benny in you. He won't anoint you. He won't
use you.
No images in you. No images. Pastor's wife was asking me, he said, I don't know why these people ask me strange questions. He said, do not bless him. You know, what do you think of facelift and all that? And the husband was just sitting, watching me. I know he was praying for prophet. Oh God, have mercy. Oh God, have blessing. I said, sister, I don't care about facelift and all that. Jesus said he's coming for a church without spot or wrinkles. So you can lift all the wrinkles. It's okay with me. But make sure God can find you. Angels are sent to bring you gift. Angels should not go home and say, God, we can't find them. This is
strange.
In a pastor's conference, after the conference, I'm praying for people. After that, I'm just sitting, talking with the pastors, laughing. And a pastor's wife come again. He said, Prophet Bernard, people criticize my hairdo. What do you think of my hairdo? I look at the hairdo. I knew she copied it from somebody. But everybody's calf is different. Your head is different from the head of that sister. So it's not all hairdo that will fit your face. When I saw the hairdo, I just look at this. I said, sister, it's very unique. Say gram. I say it's very unique. Because I look at the hairdo. It doesn't fit the face. No sense of worth. Copying people. Be original. Don't be a carbon copy. Be original. Amen.
Amen.
I meet some Tamil brothers and sisters, and when they are talking, I mean, it's almost like they, I mean, I say, hey, where do you come from?
Canadian, American.
And I was walking with a pastor, I remember a pastor whose son was acting like that. You know, you know, pastor, you know, it's okay, fine. And he stepped on something, you know, and that thing really hit. He said, oh yeah! But before then, when we were going, he just tricked and said, ouch. A little slip said, ouch. But when it was deep, he said, I said, now. Now the real thing is coming out. Now the real thing is coming out. From ouch to I said, yes. The real thing is coming out. God doesn't use perfect
people.
This is his team. The things that are not to nullify the things that are. Continue. So that no one may what? Boast before him. Now go to Isaiah 49. Now it's going to make sense. Let's go to Isaiah 46. Verse 8. Isaiah 46, verse 8. Now it's going to make sense. And I'm about to pray for everybody here. I'm going to take my time and minister to you. At a point, we'll close the service, but I will wait here. If I have to sleep here, I'll sleep here. You can't be lazy and do this work. I'm eager to minister to you. I'll stay as long as possible. Remember this, fix it in mind and take it to heart. So why? What is that? Now let's go. Verse 9. Remember the former things. Which means read the Bible, read the Old Testament. And find out all the miracles, all the great things God did. Don't forget them. Teach the stories to your children. Let them remember what God has done. Those of long ago, I am God and there is no other. Tell the next person, remember this. Come on, tell the next person, remember this. Fix it in mind. Take it to heart. Tell the next person, he is God. And he has no competition. Tell him, he is God. And there is none like him. So you will not find anyone or anything that you can compare with God. He doesn't have anything that can be compared to him. So when you deal with God, you are not dealing with Christians. You are not dealing with bishops. You are dealing with God. I tell Christians, God is not Christian. He is God. Just that Christians have hijacked him. God, Jesus is not Christian.
Yes,
Jesus is not Christian.
Yes,
he's God. He's God. So in case Christians have hurt you or disappointed you, that is different. But Jesus will never, never fail you. He's never failed. He's different. So Mahatma Gandhi got it wrong when he says, I like Jesus, I read in the Bible, but the Christians are the problem. It doesn't really make sense. Because Jesus is the head. Christians together are the body of Christ. So how can you love the head of somebody and hate his body? It doesn't make sense. All Christians together are the body of Christ. Christ is the head. How can you love the head and hate the body? So if you love Jesus, it will reflect in the way you value believers in Christ and the way you connect with him. That's why the Bible says if we say we love God, we don't see, but hate our brothers, we are lying. Our love for Jesus must be seen in the way we treat each other.
நாங்கள் தேவர் இயேசுவுக்கான எங்கள் அன்பு நாம் மற்றவர்கள் எப்படி கையாளுவது காணப்பட வேண்டும்.
I'm God and there is none.
நான் தேவன் வேறொருவரும் இல்லை.
I am God and there is none like me.
நான் தேவன் என்னைப் போல ஒருவரும் இல்லை.
You have not met anybody like God.
தேவனைப் போல ஒருவரை பார்க்க முடியாது.
Nobody so far. If you have been born again 50 years, 60 years, you've not met any human being like God. He's a different, totally different person. Remember this. Fix it in your mind. Cherish it. Keep it to heart. Continue. What next? I make known the end from the beginning. From ancient times, what is still to come, I say, my purpose will stand.
And then
I would do all, not some, all that I please.
அந்தத்தில் உள்ளவைகளை ஆதிமுதற்கொண்டு என்ன செய்யப்படாத பூர்வகாலம் அறிவிக்கிறேன். என் ஆலோசனை நிலையம் எனக்கு சித்தமானவைகளை எல்லாம் செய்வேன்.
Don't forget this.
இதை மறக்க வேண்டாம்.
If you forget anything in the Bible, he said, don't remember this. Fix it to the mind.
இதை ஞாபகம்
forget this. He said, I declare the end from the beginning. I declare the end. I determine the end from the beginning. Okay, so watch this. What it means is that God finishes anything before he started. We human beings start to finish. Before he start.
நாங்கள் ஆரம்பித்துதான் முடிக்கிறோம். தேவனோ அவர் முடித்து விட்டால் ஆரம்பிக்கும் முன்பா.
Everybody touch your coconut.
சேர்ந்தாய் தொடுங்க.
Say this, remember this. Fix it in mind. Take it to heart.
இதயத்திலே வைங்க.
Amen.
Amen.
So get this.
அது தெரியா
போய் God finishes anything.
Example.
How many of you know a script writer, movie writers, those who write the movie? How many of you understand who a script writer is? Let me see my hand. The script writer, he would write the movie from beginning to end. Then when he ends the movie, it's ended. Then he will go out and look for actors. To come on the set and act what is already finished. What is already written. So before your mother met your father and thought of having a baby, God knew you. And God finished you. He finished every aspect of your life. Then called you onto this earth. Released you in Christ. To begin to live out what he has already written about you.
அவர் உங்களை குறித்து எல்லாவற்றையும் முடித்து விட்டார். அதன் பின்புதான் அவர் கிறிஸ்துவுக்குள்ளே நீங்கள் நடக்கிறீர்கள்.
Don't forget this.
இதை மறக்க வேண்டாம்.
Say this after me. I'm a finished product. Say that again. I am a finished product. So God has finished you. And you are here to live out what he has already finished. When the actors come on the set, they cannot do their own thing. Because the movie has been finished. So when they come, the director will position them in the set. According to that which is written. And you give them a script. And they are supposed to read the script. Memorize it. Believe the script. Act like the script.
And
when they do that, He rewards them. Same thing for a Christian. The day you got born again, you gave your life to Jesus, God was not shocked. God didn't go, that guy too saved. He's already finished it. He knew the day you come to church. He knew the day you lift your hands. He knows that moment you give your life to Jesus. So the very moment you give your life to Jesus, God told the angels, I told you. Now rejoice. I know some actors would like to come on the scene and do their own thing. The director will say, cut! Redo it.
Cut!
So the Holy Spirit is the director of the movie. That tells us what to do, what not to do, how to move, what to drink, what to wear, where to go, who to talk to on the set. If you don't own your life, as long as you enlist to be an actor on this movie, you are under the director's control, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Are you? Now, I know some of you come on the set and said, I want this role. Director said, no. Based on what I've written, you can't fit this role. You fit that role.
He
said, no. As a matter of fact, some parents would tell the actor, you don't have to take this role, take that right. So parents will tell your child, when you grow, be a doctor. You have to be a doctor. My sister's brother's nephew was a doctor. You have to be a doctor. Then the director, who is the Holy Spirit, said, no. You are not a doctor, you are an actor. You are a lawyer. So you can meet a doctor who is a lawyer inside. And if the doctor is a lawyer inside, he will be always arguing with his patients.
You'll
meet people like that. They are outside God's will, outside God's plan for their lives. They can never be content. Some people are jealous of everybody. They will never be happy for anyone because they are outside what they were wired to be and do. Nandri. On the set, nobody acts the same on the set. Everybody has a script. So God has a different calling for all of us. The God of the Bible, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He has a different calling for all of us. And the role you are supposed to play determines the script he's giving you. But the script is put together as a movie. So when you go on a set, the director has the whole movie, which is the Bible, the Word of God. But in the scriptures, you have a place. Everybody has a place in the scripture. There is a verse in the Bible that describes you. It describes who you are, what you are supposed to do, what you're not supposed to do. It describes everything. And Jesus found his when he entered the temple. They gave him the prophet, the book of Isaiah. And the Bible says he opened the book and found the place that was written. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Thank you. He's anointed me. Thank you. He found his job description in the manual. God has a manual for you. There is a scripture in the Word of God and I pray this week you'll find it. Lift your hands and shout hallelujah. You will find it, that word.
சரியாக நடிக்காவிட்டால் மீண்டும் நடிக்கும்.
Do you know that the movie actors and the movie industry, they can repeat the same scene for about 20 days trying to get one scene correct? The Holy Spirit can touch on the same thing in your life over and over again.
ஒரு திரைப்பட காட்சி செய்கிறவர் ஒரு காட்சியை சரியா செய்தால் 20 தடவை கூட அவர்
செய்வார். Some of you get angry and said, I don't like it anymore. You will not be a celebrity. You missed the reward. Act in God's movie, you are a celebrity here on earth and in heaven. When you walk on the red carpet of the blood of Jesus,
and
angels follow you everywhere you go, like cameras. Doors open before
you.
He finishes, then he starts.
So
whenever we are living on earth
as
believers in Christ,
and
problems come and challenges come, God is not moved because he knows the end. I'm watching a movie with my daughter, Miracle. My first daughter. And this guy's head is on the rail line. The head of this guy was on the rail, you know, the train. And the train is coming. I forgot myself. And I scream, ha! Daddy, take it easy. I've watched this movie. That guy did not die. He was the hero. Then the Holy Spirit breaks my heart. Said, this is what happens. I knew the end of the movie of your life.
So
when problems and challenges come, I tell you, relax. Be still and know that I'm God. I know how this is going
to
end. Take it easy. We'll get to the end. Bless that end from the beginning. He says, my purpose will stand. His movie will be successful. How many of you love to watch a boring movie? You don't. How many of you want a very interesting movie? So God can start the movie of your life on the backside, on the difficult side, where all the problems and challenges and struggles, and then that's one scene. You don't stop there. As you progress in the movie, things begin to change. You don't give up watching the movie halfway and go, you move on. And the movie of God is full of drama, suspense. And that's Pharaoh and his horsemen coming. And Moses is standing by the Red Sea. And the Jewish people said, we will kill you. By the count of three, two. And God is saying, Moses. So the Jewish people want Moses' attention. The Egyptians want Moses' attention, and God is also calling him Moses. Suspense. And God said, Moses, leave the people and come up here. People said, if you go, we'll stone you, we'll kill you. And it's suspense. Then Moses comes up. And God asks him, Moses, what is in your hand? Don't ask me questions. You know what the problems I'm going through. You better help me and stop asking me questions. It's amazing when you are going through challenges and problems how God will ask you questions. Very annoying. Pastor, pray for me. The pastor will ask you, what do you want God to do for you? So, but you were a pastor, you are supposed to know. Suspense, drama. Jesus meet Bartimaeus. Bartimaeus is blind. And he, Jesus, son of David, have mercy, bring him. And the guy comes, and Jesus asks him, what do you want with? And I'm saying, Jesus, can't you see the guy is blind? Drama, suspense, twist and tense. Moses said, you don't ask me questions. Help me now. Do something. Moses, what's in your hand? It's a stick. That's all you need. That's the solution. Yes. Do something with what I gave you. The solution to the problem is connected to something I've already given. Again. Say that again. I've already given you something. A talent, a skill, ability. I've given you a scripture, a verse, a promise. I've given you anointing. My spirit lives in you. I've given you something. And the solution to the problem is connected to something I've already given you. Could be the relative, the friend, the schoolmate, the job man. Could be the pastor, the church you are in. Could be the training you've had in the past. God will give you solutions connected to something He's already given you. The solution is always around you, within your reach. But it takes the grace of God to discover it. Now the Red Sea opens. Red Sea standing on each side. Okay, tell me, let's go. Me? Go through the sea? I'm going to Sri Lanka. See you later. I'm not moving 1 inch. Going through the sea? No, Jaffna. See you in Jaffna. I'm not moving 1 inch. The sea? That is how I know these people did not come from Sri Lanka. If they came from India, Sri Lanka, Africa, they will never go through the sea. They'll be there praying for the Holy Spirit to give them confirmation before they go. We will not move it. The sea open. I mean, imagine a sea is open, standing on each side. And you expect the Indian brother or Sri Lankan sister to walk through? No! Pastor, praise God, close the service, let's go home. It's not going to happen. They're not going to go. And the Jews will not move 1 inch. The same people who are complaining. And the miracle has happened. They will not move. Be careful what you ask God for. The Red Sea is open. Go! No, So God allowed Pharaoh and his terrors to advance. Please, I want you to turn to somebody. Tell him, God solved problems with problems.
I'm
talking about the God of the Bible. The God
of the Bible.
I'm talking about Jesus Christ. He solved problems with a problem. So now problem is coming. The chariots are coming. You can't go left or right. You can't go back. Pharaoh is coming. You have to move forward. That's why God gives you a forward feet and a forward face. Whatever happens in your life, you move forward. Imagine you see somebody somewhere in Finch walking like this. What will you think of the person? Something wrong with the coconut. So you don't dwell on the past. You don't always rely on your past failures, your past fears. No! In the kingdom of God, in the family of Jesus, you keep moving forward, looking unto Jesus, the starter and the finisher of your faith. He said, move! Now, the chariots are coming. So you have to go through that miracle by force. You have to go through that. They have to run. They don't have time to look on the sides. Because Pharaoh and his soldiers are coming. They all got to the end. And still Pharaoh and his soldiers are coming. Moses!
Moses!
Wake up! The guys are coming. Suspense. And God tells the angels, watch me. This is nice. I'm going to turn Pharaoh's army into fish food. He will finish it and start. His purpose will stand. God's purpose for your life will prevail. It will succeed. It will overcome. Connect with the purpose of God. Give Him your life. Some of you are so stingy, you will not even give Jesus your problems. So stingy. Nappy. They will not give Jesus their problems. Jesus said, give me your problems. Cast all your cares upon Him. He cares for you. He said, Ama, Aka, give me the problem. No, let me worry about it for 2 weeks. How can you be on a flight still carrying your luggage? The flight is Jesus. The air hostess is the Holy Spirit. He comes and says, can I please put your baggage in the gross compartment? No. Tonight you need to give Him all the sorrows, all the pain, the fears. Give Him the problems. Roll the problem like a ball in the hands of God and let go. Stop worrying about that situation. Give it up. God has a beautiful purpose for your life. And the end of the movie of your life is victory, 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 victory,
victory,
victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, victory, Proverbs 19:20, can you see that there? Proverbs 19:20, before we pray. Proverbs 19:20, quickly. Listen. He said, listen to advice and what? Accept instruction. And in the end, you'll be what? Wise. In the end, you'll be what? In the middle, you look like a fool.
மத்தியிலே நீங்கள் ஒரு முட்டாள் போல காணப்படலாம்.
When you start, people will laugh at you.
நீங்கள் ஆரம்பிக்கும் போது ஜனங்கள் உங்களை பார்த்து சிரிக்கலாம்.
But when we listen to divine advice,
ஆனால் தெய்வீக ஆலோசனைகளை கேட்கும் போது,
at the end of the movie,
அந்த திரைப்படத்தின் முடிவு,
we will realize,
அது அறிந்து கொள்வீர்கள்,
that it was a wise decision.
அது ஞானமான தீர்மானம் அறிந்து கொள்வீர்கள்.
When Jesus was born, wise men came to seek him. Up to now, is the wise that seek Jesus.
இயேசு பிறந்த போது ஞானவான்கள் இயேசுவை தேடி வந்தார். இதுவரைக்கும் ஞானவான்கள் தான் இயேசுவை கண்டுகொள்றார்கள்.
You cannot fail.
நீங்கள் ஒருநாள் தோல்வியடைய முடியாது.
Yielding to the Spirit of Christ.
இயேசுவோட கிறிஸ்துவோட இணையும் போது தோல்வியடைய முடியாது.
To the Word of God. Go back to Isaiah 46.
Isaiah 46 க்கு போங்க.
And look at verse 10.
அதான் அதே பாருங்க.
Isaiah 46 verse 10.
Isaiah 46 10.
And see there.
அங்க பாருங்க.
Is somebody receiving something tonight? Are you receiving something tonight? Lovely. I make known the end from the beginning, from the ancient times, what is still to come. I say, my people for standing, I'll do all that I please. Let's look at verse 11, quickly. Verse
11.
From the east I send on a bird of prey, from a far off land, a man to fulfill my purpose. What I have said, that I will bring about, what I have planned, that will I do. What he has planned and what he has said he will do.
குரானியரோட பட்டியை கேட்டிருந்தும் என் ஆலோசனை நிறைவேற்றும் ஒரு மனிதனை தூரதேசத்து வரவழைக்கிறவாய்ப்பேன். அதை சொன்னேன், அதை நிறைவேற்றுவேன், அதை திட்டம் பண்ணினேன், அதை செய்து முடிப்பேன். நான் திட்டம் போட்டதை செய்து முடிப்பேன்.
ஆமென்.
ஆமென்.
Look at Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3 quickly. Ephesians 1:3-6.
எபேசியர் 1:3-6 வரை.
It's a Bible study. Ephesians 1 This is God's program, God's agenda. Let's all read. Ready, go. Praise be to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms. Tell the next person, you are blessed. Oh, tell him again. Tell her again, you are blessed. Come on, come on, turn around. Tell him you are blessed. Tell him you are blessed. Tell him again, you are not burdened, you are blessed. Who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. Tell the next person, you have every spiritual blessing. You have every spiritual blessing. Tell the next person, you need to be glad you sat close to me. Because I am blessed. Tell him, because I'm blessed with every spiritual blessing. Amen. In Christ. Continue quickly. For he chose us. How many of you see that? For he chose us in him. Who is the him? Jesus. He chose us in Jesus. Before. Don't forget, God finishes anything before he what? He started. So when did Jesus choose you? Before the creation of the world. So before the world was created, for the Garden of Eden to be created, for Adam and Eve to be created, for Satan to tempt Eve, So that we would need a savior. Before all that, God knew all of us and chose all of us to be born again in Christ. He finished it, then started it. He chose us before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight in love. In him. That was it, in him. So when you enter into Jesus, you become holy and blameless. And you are in love, not hatred, in love. Everybody say, come in love. No, move your body. Some of you too stay forward. Say, I'm in love. Oh my God. I can't get you to exercise. Some of you will never go to the gym. This is the only time I can get you to exercise. Okay, let's lose some weight. Say, I'm in love. You lost 6 pounds right now. You're doing well. In love. So anytime you enter Christ, you receive Jesus as your Savior, you are blameless before God, you are holy before God, and you are in love. Tell the next person that you need to be glad you sat close to me. Tell him I'm full of love. Tell him don't be afraid of me. I'm just love. Amen. I'm just love. So hatred is illegal for a believer in Christ. It is illegal. It is illegal for a believer to hate anyone. It's illegal. When people squeeze you, love must come out. Amen. You are in love. Before the foundations of the earth. So before Satan and demons came, Jesus has already chosen you. You were already born again. You were already made holy through the blood of Jesus. You are already blameless before God. And you are already full of love. You are in love. You are not having love. You are in love. You are baptized in love. When you cough, love comes out. Are you here?
Yes.
Good. Let's go to Romans 8, verse 30. Romans 8, 30. Please close this door. We are sleeping here tonight. No. We will close that. Please. Forgive this brown Indian boy. And those he determined their end before they began. Destination, the end. So he determines the end from the beginning. We, whose end has been determined before we began, he also called. So after he finished us, then he called us. The word called means ekligo. Say ekligo. It was ekligo. It means scream. Hi! So that's how the call of God is like. Scream. Those he predestined, he screamed. That is why when God, Pastor, you didn't scream. Thank you. How generous. Thank you. So when the God of the Bible calls you, when Jesus calls you, you can't run away from the call. It's a shout in your spirit. It's a scream in your mind. You can drown it, you can smoke everything from bamboo to grass, and still you can hear that sound. You said, no, listen, I don't care about Jesus, I hate this God, I hate this church, I hate the pastors, and God, and one day you are in the disco dancing. And whilst you are dancing, the Holy Spirit says, oh, it's time to give your heart to me. And now you come out, you come and sit in the car. You say, Jesus, I don't even know why I came to this place. Please forgive me. Ah! He called you. Can you give him a hand for that? He's screaming at you, shouting at you, emailing messages in your head, faxing messages in your head. You'll be bathing in the shower, and in the shower, the Holy Spirit will come to and start speaking to you. You can't drown the voice of God. You can't drown it. Tell that he determined their end before the beginning. Those he finished them before he started. After he's finished them, then he started them by calling them.
அவர் முன்குறித்து முடித்த பின்பு தான் அவர் அழைக்கிறார்
So in eternity God finished all of us then he looked into his belly and he goes Bernard blessing are you ready now you have two people having some nice time there get ready quickly get ready come on get ready Bernard blessing get ready get ready get ready and just when mom and dad came together he said move and zoom Bernard blessing entered the womb dancing like a taco and it takes 3 days when the intercourse takes place 3 days millions of sperm start a race to the egg 3 days race the hottest marathon takes place in the womb and Bernard Blessing is among these millions of sperm and God is cheering Bernard Blessing Bernard that's my boy Tell someone, tell him, this is God's program. God's agenda. So God is cheering you. Then they said, go!
And we are running.
And at times I will fall. And God said, get up, move. And I'm moving. After 3 days, among the millions and millions of sperm, it's only one that wins the race. And guess who won it? It's you that won the race. Before even you were born, you were a winner. In the womb, you won. Millions of sperm. And it's interesting, biology, science is nice. Science only discovers what God has covered.
Pastor,
what happened? You went to heaven and came back. Small tail. When it gets to the egg, the sperm gets to the egg, the big head enters the egg and the tail falls off. So the Bible says you are the head and not the tail. It proves the word of God. Ayo. It proves the word of God. Oh, can you give Jesus praise? What God has covered. And science is always slow. It takes us a long years to discover one thing God made. And we call it an invention. Very interesting. You get that big head enters and the tail falls off. So the Bible says you are the head and not the tail. The tail doesn't make decisions. The tail only follows where the head is going. So there are people like that, they follow everybody. They don't make any decision with their coconut. But God says you are the head, which means you are a leader. You lead, others follow. Amen. You lead. You don't copy anybody, you are original. You are
authentic.
In Romans 8:30, it's interesting. He said, them that he predestined, which means he has before determine their end. Before they began, he has determined
their end.
He called. He screamed at. So among your schoolmates, your classmates, all of them were misbehaving. You were also living your life chaotic. And suddenly, there was a scream from heaven. Among your relatives, of all of them, you heard that voice. Because God knew you before the foundations of the earth. And that is why no demon or witch or wizard will be able to touch your life. You don't allow any human being to make you feel as if you are nothing. This young guy, you know, as one of my sons, you know, before he got saved, I met him and this girl has jolted him He said it's a girlfriend, and the girlfriend had just, I said, let her go, it's okay. I wanted to get him saved. And he would not listen. He said, please help me write an apology letter to her. I said, me? I should help you write an apology letter. I said, no, let it go. He said, no, I cannot live without her. I would die. I said, trust me, 2 weeks' time you'll be alive. I would die. I said, no. Later on, he got saved. He got filled with the Holy Spirit. And recently, he told me, he said, Papa, I saw that girl. God forgive me for asking that girl should come back. Because God knew the end, he didn't.
He didn't.
Them that he predestined, he also called. How if you hear the scream of God in your heart? When you feel like giving up on Christ, you still keep going on. Are you hearing me? You feel like you will stop this church thing, this Bible study, this reading thing, this jumping, singing, you tired of it, and still there's something in you still drawing you. That is why the devil has tried everything to destroy you, but has failed. The suffering hands of the Creator hovers on your life, leading you. Listen, he called. And those he called, he also what? Justified. Pastor Julio, come. See, I called Pastor. I called him. Now, you know what Pastor is thinking? There should be a reason for me calling him, isn't it? So when God calls us, there is a reason why he called us. There should be something he wants us to do. So God didn't just call you to be born again, be a believer, come to church and sit like a piece of wood. No, God has a purpose for your life. There's something he wants you to do. He has a specified plan for your life in this nation and around the world. But them that God called, he realized, oh, they are not perfect. Mistakes, weaknesses. I told him he doesn't use perfect people. And you know his team. How many of you know God's team? So he called us, but realized, wait a minute, a lot of work to be done. And God knows he has an enemy. And the enemy will always be accusing him. You call this person, look at him. So when God called us, then he made us look as if we have never sinned before. It's called justification. Just as if you have never sinned. Through his blood, he declared us holy, blameless. Just as if we have not sinned. He justified us. So he predestined us. Determined our end before our beginning. Then he made us look as if we've not sinned. Then he glorified us. Seated with Christ in heavenly places. Far above every negativity. Far above every demon. Every witch. Every wizard. Far above everything wrong. Look at those words. It's all past tense. Predestined past called past tense. Justified past tense. And glorified past tense. So before you receive Jesus, God has already glorified you. Before you receive Christ, it's already set for you. But it's all in Jesus. So when you receive Jesus, all these things become a reality. So a person who received Jesus is a glorified person. Tonight I'm touching glorified hands.
நான் இந்த ராத்திரி வரையிலே மகிமை உள்ள கரங்களை தொடுறேன்.
I'm walking with a glorified pastor.
நான் மகிமை உள்ள போதகர் நடக்கிறேன்.
He's glorified pastors. It's not now that Jesus is going to sit with a church committee to decide should I glorify him or not. No, past tense, glorified. So some of you that have enemies and you think because of your enemies you will never realize God's purpose for your life. Oh, wake up, smell the coffee. This is a new day. Is that okay? You are already glorified. Can you lift your glorified hand? Can you shout from your glorified lips? Say, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, glorified words are coming out of me. Glory. Wherever you go, the glory of God flows. You are a carrier of glory. The word glory means doxa. Doxa in the Greek. Doxa. It means all that God is, all that God has, and all that God can do. Glory means doxa. Doxa means all that God is, His nature. All that God has is power. And all that God can do. So when God says He has glorified us, it means you are like Daddy. You are like God. You have the authority of God. You have the wisdom of God. You have the excellence that flows from
God.
You have the heart of God. A heart of compassion, a heart of
love.
You have the springs of humility flowing
through
you. You have diligence out of you. You have faithfulness in
you.
You are honest. You are strong. You are dependable. You have the wisdom of God. You have the nature of God. Doxa. Glory. All that God is. All that He has. And all that He can do. Glory. When you wake up, glory has woken up. When you are bathing, that is a glorified bath. You are taking a glorified shower. When you touch anything, you transfer glory to it. That is why some years ago somebody stole my clothes. I washed my clothes, hung it outside, and somebody stole it. I said, this is the easy way to be born again. I said, this is easy. Within 25 minutes, they brought that person crying, holding my clothes. Because the glory of God has transferred into those clothes. That guy was gripped by the Holy Spirit, crying. He gave me the clothes before he could talk properly. He was shaking like a leaf. Yes, thank you. This time, steal the not bad blessings clothes. You are glorified. And this whole thing was very expensive. It cost God His blood. This package. So you can't handle it anyhow. This very expensive package. So if you don't believe it, receive it, and use it, you've wasted the blood of Jesus. You've devalued the blood. You have devalued the slap and the beatings He received. Look down on
it.
Pastor, I'm just a worm. You are not just a worm. Satan doesn't like worms. That's why the devil wants you. If you are nothing, why is Satan so interested in you? Whatever you see the devil attack, it means God has an investment there.
Anywhere you see the devil
attack, it means God has an investment there. God has made investments in you, talents, skills, abilities. God has poured so much in you. And that's why every demon and witch wants you destroyed. You are carrying God's treasure. You see the bank cards that transfer
money.
You see the security they give to that car.
Not for the driver.
Adu driver kala.
No. Not for the car.
There
is a treasure in the car.
அந்த வாகனத்துக்குள்ளே பொக்கிஷம் உண்டு.
And the scripture says there's a treasure in the earthen vessel, which means there is a treasure God has placed in believers in Christ. So you carry God's treasure. That is why you have heavenly security. Angels on guard. The angels of God surround the dwelling of the righteous. Angels are on guard. You are sleeping, snoring like the trains. And angels are standing in attention. You are carrying God's treasure. Jacob is down there. Sleeping. Bad boy. Bad boy, this is rascal, and he's sleeping on a stone. And God can allow wild animals to eat him up for lunch.
For dinner,
the guy is sleeping. But angels are moving to and fro on the ladder. This bad guy. Rascal, and you're protecting him. Angels, every second. It takes a second to go on a ladder. And the ladder was full. Every second, an angel leaves the earth to heaven and heaven to the earth.
Over a second,
you know why? That guy is carrying God's treasure. There are 12 sons in his
loins.
One of them is called Judah. And Judah will produce David. And David will bring us the Messiah. God sees treasures in you. There is so much in you that will help people, that will help many people, that will change lives. Tonight, look beyond you. The destinies of many are connected to you. That is why it's easy for miracles to come to you tonight. Because when you receive the miracle, it will encourage others. It will draw many souls to Christ. It will liberate many. It will wipe tears and heal hearts. That's why the Holy Spirit is in a hurry to bless you. He's in a hurry to do good to you. Because every time he does good to you, he gains. God gains nothing doing nothing for you. That's why he said, even if you are faithless, I'm faithful. As human beings, you see the way we protect our investment. Please try to take the bag of the person next to you. Try to take the bag. See, the person is entering into the spirit right now. Start speaking in tongues. I rebuke that in Jesus' name. Because there's a treasure in the bag. For all you know, it's two rats. It's two rats in the bag, but he's protecting the rats. He's protecting the treasure. We human beings know how to protect. How much more God? He placed a spirit in you. Gave you his image. Gave you his creation. Free of charge. Gave you life. Then shed his blood. Gave his son. Give us the Holy Spirit. Talents and skills. Give us the church. The pastor. Bless you with a relative friend. And the best blessing, give us the devil. So you will be a good trainer. Help teach you how to pray, how to fast, how to come to church, how to obey God. Very generous. He's invested too much in us. Say this after me, I'm predestined.
Say
it with faith in you. I say, I'm predestined.
In
Christ Jesus. Say, I'm called by Christ Jesus. Say, I'm called in Christ. Say, I'm justified. I am just as if I've not sinned ever in my life. Say, through the blood of Jesus, I am blameless. I am washed. I am scrubbed clean. I'm free from every sin, every fallenness, every weakness is gone. I'm free in Jesus' name. I'm justified. Say this after me, in Jesus' name, in Christ, I'm glorified. Say, I have a glorified family, glorified marriage, glorified parents, glorified business. Say, I have a glorified body. Tell the next person, this is the address of the Holy Spirit. Point to the body, say, this is the address of the Holy Spirit. This is the temple of the Holy Spirit. This is the house. Tell the next person, there's glory here. There's glory here. There's glory here. Amen.
Amen.
Now, how many of you accept this? How many of you receive this? How many of you believe this? If you believe this, then the next verse. If you believe this, then the next verse. What then shall we say in response to this? If you believe this, that you are, your end has already been determined. That you have a glorious end. It's already done. It's set. And you know He's called you. And you have a right standing with God. Justified. If you believe this, what will your speech be? What are the things you will say? How will you talk? And he says, in case you forget how to talk, when you believe this, I'll tell you. He says, if God is for us, who can be? So people who believe this talk like that. If God is for me, who? Say who?
Who?
Let me see your lips. Pull that thing out. Say who?
Who?
Who? Who? Again? Who?
Who?
Some of you is still inside. Bring it out. Say who?
Who?
Who? If God be for me, if God be for us, if God be for you, who? Who? Who is that demon? Who is that witch? Who is that wizard? A brother was telling me, I had a dream. I saw a cow wearing sari chasing me in the cow. I said, how did the cow get into your bedroom and into your dream? How did it get there? How? In a very funny way, I asked him, what did you eat last night? He said, corned beef sandwich. I said, the corned beef you ate is the mother-in-law taking vengeance on you. It's got nothing to do with any spirituality. If God be for you, who can be? Say that if God be for me, who can be against me? Say it again, who can be against me? Which means no fear. Fear is gone. The fear of men. The fear of suffering. The fear of failure. The fear of death. The fear of failing. The fear of rejection. Who can be against? This is how you talk when you believe the package. If you believe the package, this is how you talk. Continue quickly. John. Let's go. Continue. He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us what? What does all things mean in Canada? Everything. Say everything. 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 Apart. Everything. everything. Tell me everything. Everything.
You
go to church and they pray for things and they pray for things. He said he will give us everything along with Jesus. Everything. Everything. Along with him. Extra. This is a blank check. If somebody gives you a blank check, don't write $2. Continue. Sister Anna, are you there? Good. Okay. Are you okay? Good. Okay. Tighten your seatbelt now. Okay. He said, who will bring any charge against those who God has what? So when people accuse you and slander you and all that, don't panic. Go and find some nice, you know, monkey biryani and eat and relax. It is God who justifies. Continue. Who is he that condemns? If people, somebody's condemning you, who is that person? Who is that person? My pastor friends will say, some believe that the rapture will come before we go. Some believe we'll go before the, all kinds of things. And they ask me, prophet, what is the truth? I say, I agree with all of you. When he comes, we go. They want to complicate everything. Who is he that condemns? So they are condemning each other. This person said pre-millennium. This say after millennium. I said, so what is all this? And they hate each other because of the doctrinal difference. I said, when he comes, we go. Yes, I agree with all of you. Let's move on. Who condemns? Christ Jesus, who died more than that, that he was raised life, who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God, who is also interceding for us. Continue. Tell this person, God, Jesus is praying for you. I came to church, nobody lay hands on me. Jesus is praying for you. For some people, you do everything, but still they will not believe. You lay your hands and legs on them, they will still do that. Nothing will change in the coconut. Okay, let's move on. Continue. Verse 36. Continue. Verse 37. Let's do that. Say, no, in all these things, we are more than what? Conquerors. Through him who what? Loved us. Continue. How many of you believe the package? You believe God's program? You believe. Then tonight, say this, for I am convinced. Say that. Say, now I am convinced. Say, knowing what I know tonight, I am persuaded. I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor demons, neither present, nor future, nor any powers. Continue. Neither height, nor depth, nor anything else, in all creation, anything else, say anything else, in all creation, will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor. This is better than swallowing aspirins.
Aspirin,
A pastor told me, he said, prophet, I had a dream. And I was going up. And you know, I knew he just wanted to make something big out of the dream. There was no spiritual significance to the dream. He said, "Oh, what was going on?" So in a funny way, I want to get his attention. I said, "Then you're about to die." He said, "Prophet, then I started coming down." Most people want sensationalism. They want things. They want their itchy ears. They just want to make something out of something. Tell the next person, keep it simple, saints. KISS. 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 Keep it simple, saints. Not stupid, saints. Is that okay? Okay, good. Amen. Are you here with me? Are you here with me?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
You here?
Yes.
Are you here?
Yes.
Can you lift your hands in prayer? Thank you, Holy Spirit. My brother, can you beam that on the board as we lift our hands in prayer? 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 9. Can you beam it up? Oh, hallelujah. No eyes have seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has what? Prepared, which is past tense. Prepared, already prepared.
Prepared
for those who love
him.
But see verse 10. Tonight wonderful things are happening. Verse 10. But God has revealed it to us by what?
Spirit.
Say, Holy Spirit, reveal. Reveal what you've already prepared for me. The Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. Tonight there's somebody that knows the script of your life. He knows the movie of your life. He knows
what you're doing to the end.
And his thoughts about you are good, not evil. To bring you to an expected end, not a disappointed end. He is the Spirit of Christ Jesus. The Holy Spirit. Your eyes cannot see him because he's bigger than anything created. Because he is the creator. He loves you so much he doesn't want to see him physically because you melt out. He is bigger than the sun you cannot look at. But he's close to you than the person sitting next to you. And he's calling you out of any negativity, out of any wrong thing. He's calling you out of any bondage. He's calling you out of anything that is troubling you. He's willing to forgive every sin you've committed. He's willing to give you a new spirit, a new heart. The God kind of life. He's willing to fill you with that which is heavenly. He wants to do impossible things through you. You are the Joseph of your family. You are the Esther of the family. You are the blessing carrier. You are the one that carried the blessing of God. You will not live this year like you lived it last year. It's a new year. It's a new chapter of your life. It's a new era. It's a new day. It's a new season. It's a new moment. And tonight, his program for your life will prevail. He has blessed you with all.
Ella
unseen blessings. His blessing is unseen, but it produces seen events. It changes seen conditions, physical conditions. There is something unseen on your life called the blessing of God that will produce something visible. I want you to begin to lift your hands and begin to pray in the Spirit, begin to thank Him right now. Begin to thank Him. Open your mouth and thank Him. The flesh hates the presence of God, the body. But the spirit man is rejoicing. The spirit man is eating beautiful meals from God. The food of your spirit is the word of God. You follow Jesus for 3 days hearing the word. And the greatest miracles began to flow. He fed the 4,000 and the 5,000. After feeding the Spirit, there was an overflow of miracles. Father, we thank you tonight for your presence. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The entrance of your word has destroyed the works of Satan. Diseases are evaporating right now. In the name of Jesus, sickness, get out. Disease, get out. Kidney diseases, goodbye in Jesus' name. Bladder problems being healed by the power of Christ Jesus. Bone problems being regulated by the Creator. The Creator of the bone, Jesus Christ, restores it. Be healed, my brother and sister. Be delivered from every problem, from every condition. Every harassment of the devil for your family, we declare that cancelled and terminated in Jesus' name. We rebuke any demonic force that is harassing you in any area of life. In Jesus' name, get out, devil, get out, wave goodbye. Move out of the family, get out of the children, move out of your business, get out of your finances, be gone. Receive the strength of God in your physical body. Receive the joy of God in your spirit. Break out of any demonic containment, anything holding you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive deliverance right now. Come out of any demonic delay. Any demonic delay. Things that have delayed in your life, in Jesus' name, we rebuke it. We come against it. Those demonic barriers are being removed right now by the finger of Jesus. That thing leaves your life. It gets out of your family. It gets out in Jesus' name. Whatever has stolen from you is given to you now. Things that hurt you cannot hurt you anymore. Because of Jesus. Because of the power of the Holy Spirit. This is a glorified body. You are glorified. You are glorified. It's already done. It is finished. It is finished. It is finished. You are a finished product. It is done. You've been on one scene of your movie for too long.
You
move on to the next scene. You've marked time in the same level for too long. By the help of the Holy Spirit, move up to the next phase of your life. Move up into new levels of God's blessing. Father, in the name of Jesus tonight, anything in our hearts that hinders your spirit, be it unforgiveness, ingratitude, unbelief, spiritual laziness, anything in our lives that hinders the move of your power, in the name of Jesus tonight, as your people lift their hands, by the audacity of the Holy Spirit, by the audacity of the blood of Jesus, by the authority of the name of Christ, that thing is removed right now. That thing is exterminated right now. In the name of Jesus, melt off right now. Melt off right now. If anybody has done something that hurt you, forgive the person. Release that person from your heart. Jesus said, when you stand to pray, forgive. Because unforgiveness nullifies the potency of your prayer. It nullifies the efficacy of your prayer. Unforgiveness cancels out the power of your prayer. Because if you have not forgiven, then God has not forgiven you. And if you have not forgiven, it means you still have sin, and sin separates you from God. When you stand to pray, forgive. When you stand to pray, forgive. When you stand to pray, forgive. This is how you access the unsearchable inheritance in Christ. There are three uncommon ways of living. First is giving. Second is forgiving. And third is thanksgiving. To live an extraordinary life, a significant life, a glorious life, a life of power with God, is the Trinity of virtues. Giving. To give. Forgiving. And thanksgiving. If all you know is these three things, there is no witch or wizard or demon that will be able to hold you from fulfilling your God-given assignment and purpose in life. Giving. Forgiving. And thanksgiving. Giving. For he loved the world that he gave his only son. So he's a significant God. He forgave us while we were yet sinners. He's a significant God. And when we thank him, his power fills us. His glory visits us. He responds to thanksgiving. He says one day he will thank us. He will say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. He's a God who gives, who forgives, and a God who is thankful. Tonight, in the name of Jesus, if there is any area of your life you are trusting God to visit,
இன்னொரு காரியத்திலேயாவது உங்களுடைய பவு ஜீவத்திற பகுதியில் இயேசு உங்களை சந்திக்கும் நீங்கள் விரும்பினால்
need a change in any area of your life.
உங்கள் வாழ்க்கையில் எந்த பகுதியாவது ஒரு மாறுதல் வேண்டும் நீங்கள் யோசித்தால்
lift up your hand
ore karate with you
and pray this prayer with me
enoru kuda devathe theepila
say jesus
yesuve
tonight
raatri mone
I have heard your voice
ore kurale naan kekke
and I believe in your word
ore vaathile naan nambugire
I thank you
okay nandri solugiren
that I am a member of your team
ore kurumile naan angathinoru nandri solugiren
thank you for your love
ore anbukkaga nandri
I receive
God பெற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிறேன்
all you purchased for me
எனக்காக நீர் பெற்றுக்கொண்ட எல்லாத்தையும் நான் பெற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிறேன்
on Calvary's cross
கல்வாரி சிலுவையிலாக சம்பாதித்த எல்லாத்தையும் நான் பெற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிறேன்
thank you Jesus
இயேசுவே உமக்கு நன்றி
for your love again
உம்முடைய அன்புக்காக நன்றி
I believe
நான் நம்புகிறேன்
in what you have said
நீ சொன்ன காரியம்
I receive
அதை நான் பெற்றுக்கொள்ளுகிறேன்
what you've given me
எனக்கு கொடுத்தவை
and I confess
நான் அறிக்கைப்படுத்துவேன்
with my mouth
என்னுடைய வாயினால்
believing with my heart
என்னுடைய விசுவாசத்தில்
that your purpose will stand
உம்முடைய நோக்கம் நிலைநிற்கும்
in my life
என்னுடைய ஜீவியத்திலே
in my family
என்னுடைய குடும்பத்திலே
in my children
என்னுடைய
my future
என்னுடைய எதிர்காலத்திலே
your purpose
உம்முடைய நோக்கம்
will succeed
அது வெற்றி பெறும்
in every area of my life
என்னுடைய ஜீவியத்தில் எல்லா
spiritually
ஆவிக்குரியவராக
mentally
நடப்பிரமா
emotionally
உணர்ச்சிகரமா
relationally
உறவுகள் சம்பந்தப்பட்டது
vocationally
அவருடைய வேலைகள்
financially
அவருடைய பணத்தில்
and physically
அவருடைய சரீரத்தில்
I confess
நான் அறிக்கைப்படுகிறேன்
and believe with my heart
என்னுடைய இதயத்தில் நம்புகிறேன்
that your purpose of God
உம்முடைய நோக்கம்
your purpose of Jesus
உம்முடைய இயேசுவின் நோக்கம்
will overcome
எல்லாவற்றை மேற்கொள்ளும்
against your will in my life
I
thank you Father God
that
I am in your will thank you Jesus for saving my soul for washing me with your blood for cleansing me with your blood for saving my life I have received you as my savior my deliverer my boss my God my only God thank you Father God and in Jesus name I confess tonight that any blessing Satan stole from my life is restored right now in Jesus name Father God renew my heart help me love you more show me your way help me obey you Lord I receive your strength to do your will and I declare in Jesus name any powers of darkness operating in any area of my life tonight in Jesus
name
I rebuke you I resist you I come against you say that spirit of infirmity in Jesus name get out of my life family get out of my loved ones in Jesus name spirit of poverty I resist you I rebuke you get out of my life spirit of disobedience to the Holy Spirit I rebuke you get out of my life spirit of laziness spiritual laziness come on say that spiritual laziness that affect my prayer life that affect my life of devotion spirit of laziness get out of my life get out of my life in Jesus name move out of my life get out of my life now. In Jesus name Say, Father God,
Father,
I receive supernatural strength.
Supernatural
energy.
I
receive your favor. Supernatural opportunities to share Christ with others. Say, Lord, in Jesus' name, help me be a soul winner. A person that share Christ with others. Say, in Jesus' name, I receive the fire of the Holy Ghost. I receive the power of the Spirit. I walk in the favor of God. The glory of Jesus is working through my life. Everywhere I go, I declare in Jesus' name that every relative of mine is born again. I declare it now. They are born again. They are born again. They are saved. In Jesus' name, wherever they are, in prayer, there is no distance. In the spirit world, there is no distance. I touch them now. I touch them now. Loose them. Loose them. Loose them. In Jesus' name, I rebuke the spirit of stubbornness, the spirit of hardness, the spirit of blindness. In Jesus' name, get out of your lives. Father God, I receive supernatural faith. Activate the supernatural faith in my life now. I receive it now. I walk in it now. Father, I thank you that doors that are closed in my life, tonight I declare it open. Come on, open your mouth and speak it. I declare it open. In Jesus' name. Say, Father, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, that your glory is seen in my life. In all the seven areas of my life, your glory will flow. I thank you, Father, that you have turned my curses into blessings. You turned my problems into provisions. You've turned all the mess in my life into miracles. I declare in Jesus' name, you've turned my weaknesses into your strength. I thank you, Father. I praise you, Lord. You have moved me from scarcity into divine abundance. I receive in Jesus' name. Can you stand up and begin to pray in the spirit now?